Meet J.M. Hirsch, a cooking talent who can help you get a delicious dinner on the table with minimal effort.
Food is just an integral part of who we are. And I think for a long time, Americans lost touch with some of that. You know, we had gravitated to more of the processed food, the fast food, the dashboard dining. And within the last 5 to 10 years, we've started coming back and recognizing that food does have such an important role in our communities, in our cultures, and in our families.
JM is the national food editor for the Associated Press and just released a new cookbook.
High flavor, low labor, reinventing weeknight cooking. And it's about 130-something recipes that are all weeknight friendly. You know, they use ingredients that you can get anywhere. You know, when I'm traveling around talking about it, I always use the example that I live in rural New Hampshire. If I can get these ingredients, anybody can get these ingredients.
We have some great ideas, some great recipes. J.M. Hirsch is here.
The book, just out, has become such a hit. J.M. recently appeared on ABC's Good Morning America.
The only way I can cook. And, you know, it has a lot of recipes for how to get flavorful meals fast.
And fans are lining up for book signings like this one in Concord.
My book is all about using high flavors to make our cooking faster and easier, because my theory is that if it tastes great before it goes into the pot, it takes less work from us for it to taste great when it comes out.
J.M.'s background is unique. He's not a professional chef. He initially started working for the AP covering crime and eventually moved to a new beat covering food stories, writing a weekly column covering trends in diet and nutrition and generating a new recipe every week for the AP.
The AP gave me an incredible opportunity. It really let me create a beat. We hadn't previously had a food writer before, and it was no one person's job to cover food as news. And it was a great opportunity to really get into the food world just as the entire nation was starting to pay attention.
With so many cookbooks out, what makes this one so special?
It makes a lot of sense for me as an untrained cook and somebody who really just has to get dinner on the table at the end of a crazy day, because the ingredients are doing the work for me. And so if I choose ingredients such as jalapenos and prosciutto and bacon and cheeses and spices and herbs, those ingredients are doing the work for me. And so there's a lot of wiggle room there for people such as ourselves who aren't, you know, trained cooks.
Some tips for those of you willing to follow JM's sage advice: go easy on yourself.
I think people put too much emphasis on creating the perfect dinner and worry too much about making mistakes. I make mistakes every night, you know, but that's part of learning. And so by that kind of willingness to just experiment and see what I can come up with, I think I've become an okay cook. I can get by in the kitchen. The first thing we're gonna make, it's a crostini, which is basically just a toasted slice of bread. And we're gonna top it with some apple tomato bacon jam, which is this intensely sweet and tangy and savory jam, very thick jam, and that we make in 12 minutes on the stove.
I'm not a foodie, but found cooking with JM refreshingly relaxing. He makes everything so easy in the kitchen.
I think people get intimidated by cooking, and I think that's why a lot of people don't cook, because they feel like they have to follow a recipe. And that's the first thing they should give up, is the idea that you have to follow a recipe. I don't follow my own recipes, you know? I use them as suggestions. So we are going to put some canned diced tomatoes that I've strained the water out of. And then we are going to add, this is my one indulgent recipe with bacon. It calls for a half pound of bacon, but the reality is you're only eating like a tablespoon of the jam, so it's actually not that much.
Chop some onions and simmer the ingredients together in a pan on high heat. Add a little salt and pepper.
Because what we're doing here is we're cooking the bacon, we're cooking, the tomatoes are technically already cooked. We're cooking the apple, we're cooking the bacon, and we're boiling off any moisture just to create a thick jam, and it will caramelize and thicken up very quickly.
In the meantime, I sliced up some bread, we drizzled it with olive oil, and toasted it in the oven. Then, the moment of truth.
Spread some jam on, as little or as much as you can handle.
The result?
That is excellent.
For not a lot of work, you get a lot of flavor.
That's really good.
Thank you.
You're a genius.
Nah, just a dorky dad who likes to play in the kitchen.
For our next recipe,
This is Meat Sauce Maximus. It's got the maximum amount of flavor you could possibly jam into a meat sauce for pasta.
We start with prosciutto as a base.
That just gives this incredibly deep, rich, savory flavor to the sauce. And then you're adding some ground beef, which you brown. And of course, caramelizing and browning adds a tremendous amount of flavor. And then you've got your tomatoes, which add kind of an acidic punch. And you've got tomato paste, which is an even more intense version of like a diced tomato. And it gets that kind of intense savory and tanginess. And then, you know, your kind of generic spices, your basil and your oregano, and of course your garlic. You can't have a pasta sauce without garlic. And another secret ingredient is grated Parmesan, because again, you're getting that kind of salty savoriness that just, you know, it's like the fifth taste is savory. And you know, you get your salty, your sweet, and your bitter, savory. It's wonderful. And that's one of the flavors that we really crave.
We saute our onions and spices, the seasonings and ingredients designed to give a gentle warmth to the overall flavor.
All right, so now we will add our prosciutto. And again, we're getting that savory smokiness that you get with bacon, but with a lot less fat.
In less than 30 minutes, we were done. A simple, easy sauce that tasted...
Oh, really good.
Really hot?
Just really hot.